But if you're passionate about it and you want to own your shit, independent is the way, especially now. The playing game has been evened. You could go digital yourself. Like anything that a major could put you on, you could do it yourself. And if you do your money the right way, you could market yourself. So now you don't have to go to them for their money. Like, you sell, if I sell 10, listen, I could sell, you could sell 20,000 records and make $200,000 if you do it the right way.
Right.
So if you just make a $200,000 a year, if you had a job making $200,000 a year, your whole family would be proud of you. So if you could do an album make and sell 20,000, you know what I'm saying? Well, let's just say 25 minus some expense, 25,000. You can make 200,000 off every album. So if you 360 deal, no, never. But independent, if you got a, if you got your own buzz and your own following,
so you being selfish. Do you think your son enjoys you calling somebody else a boss? Don't you think your son would rather wake up with you and you could pick him up from school instead of having to do a 9-to-5? Don't you think your son would love if his name was up there? It's my pride is in my children. Like, look what I'm doing right now. Look at my son. I taught my son never to have a boss. He's 23. He owns a restaurant. He has cookies. He has equity. He busts his ass so he can pass it on to his son. If that's not what you hustling for, you're selfish.
Me owning all of my copyrights, me owning all of my shows, me owning every movie, me owning everything, mm-hmm. has put me in a position where not only can I have a studio where 9,000 people have went through the gates to come to work last year, but also to have generational wealth for my son and his children. And if they're if they manage it right after I'm dead and gone, what that means is it's passed on to so many people. So if you want real change comes with ownership. As long as you're renting the house mm-hmm. and somebody else owns it, they have the power.